Hello students, my name is Mahesh Karbhari Mahale, working as assistant professor in SVKT College, Devadahalli Camp, Nashik. So, in today's lecture, we will discuss the rest part of the coordination chemistry. So, in previous lecture, we have discussed the nomenclature of inorganic complexes, in which we have dealt with naming of prefixes, then oxidation state of metal, then the point of attachment, then abbreviation and the bridging group for the ligands. So in that we have discussed that the naming of prefixes such as the ligands or the metals which have present outside the square bracket, we have discussed that. Then the oxidation state of that metal means if there is a coordinator complex present. So the central metal atom have some oxidation state, so it is either zero or in plus state. So if it is present in zero oxidation state, then we have written that oxidation state in bracket and mention that oxidation state in Roman letters. If it is zero, then we have written that zero in that round bracket or parenthesis. And if it is minus, then we have written that oxidation state in minus followed by the Roman letter. Then the point of attachment, if the ligand is ambidentate such as cyanide ligand, then in that case we have discussed that the point of attachment will be named first. For example, in case of cyanide, it is denoted as C, and if it is isocyanide, then it is point of attachment of that ligand is from nitrogen. So naming that ligand is followed by that C or either N. In case of nitro ligand, so nitro, it is also written as in nitrito form, in which the point of attachment will be either nitrogen or the oxygen. So meanwhile, we have discussed that the point of attachment will be based on the group which is donating to the metal atom, means which is directly coordinated to the metal atom. So point of attachment will be mentioned in so name of that ligand or name of that complex will be written as the name of attachment. For example, in case of nitrito, it is N. And in case of nitro, it is N. And in case of nitrito, it is O. So O nitro or O nitrito or N nitro group. Then abbreviation. So abbreviation such as bis, tris, tetragis. So for example, if it bidentate ligand. So in case of bidentate ligand, we write the name or the abbreviation such as bis. If that ligand repeated twice or repeated thrice, then tris. So in similar way, we have written the abbreviation for that ligand for that complex. So in that complex, then we have discussed the bridging group. So bridging groups are basically those groups which are bridge between two metal atoms. For example, in case of we have discussed that example that there was a ligand OH. So OH was bridge between two metal atoms. So that ligand was expressed in case of in such a way that we have written mu before that ligand. So mu, then followed by that name of that ligand. So there were some bridging group. So in this lecture, we will discuss the rest part of nomenclature, that is Werner's work and theory of coordination compounds. So Werner was a scientist who actually proposed the theory for the coordination complexes. So Alfred Werner, Swiss chemist, put forward the theory to explain the formation of complex compound. It was the first successful explanation, become famous as the coordination theory of a complex compounds, which also known as Werner's theory. So he was the scientist who actually discussed the part or the nomenclature or the system for the coordination chemistry, who gives the naming and the explanation for the formation of those complexes. So in order to put any theory, so there were some postulates. So he discussed some postulates. So these postulates were actually based on practical work, not on the assumption work. So in postulate, he told that the central metal atom or ion is a coordinated compound, exhibits two types of valencies. So if there is a complex, so it has two types of complexes. So central metal atom or ion coordinated with other ligands, so it has those two valencies. So first valency is primary valency and secondary valency. So basically primary and secondary valency. So primary valencies are ionizable and corresponds to the number of charge on the complex ion. So basically primary valencies are those which are present outside that square bracket known as primary valencies, or known also known as ionizable valencies. So these can be ionized, and corresponding number of those ions are written on the complex outside. So primary valencies applied equally well to simple salt, and the complex are satisfied by the negative ions. So for example, in case of this cobalt hexamine complex, so these NH3 groups, basically these NH3 groups are present in inner sphere or secondary sphere, and those chloride, which are shown in green balls, are basically present in a primary valency. So these chlorides are present in a second primary valency, and also known as ionizable valencies, or which states the oxidation state of that complex. So in second postulate, secondary valencies are correspond to the valencies that the metal atom or ion towards the neutral molecule or negative ions in the formation of its complex. So basically, in general term or in simple term, we can show that the metal atom which are directly coordinated, the ligands which are directly coordinated to the metal are basically the secondary valencies. So these are non-ionizable valencies, means comparing primary valency and secondary valency. So primary valency is basically the ionizable valency, and secondary valencies are basically non-ionizable valency. So they cannot form a separate ion, or we have discussed that the double salt and complex salt. So in complex salt, we have discussed, we can only identify the primary valency in test. So we can't find that complex, the coordinated ligands. So separate test for coordinated, we can't test for the separated ligands, coordinated ligands. So secondary valencies are directional, and so a complex has a particular shape. So in order to get any shape for that complex, so we have discussed that, or we must know that the complexes are present in a various shapes. For example, there is a tetrahedral shape, square planar shape, square pyramidal, octahedral shape. So these are various shapes. So secondary valencies are directional valencies, and they define the shape for that particular complex. So for example, in case of this complex, which is hexamine cobalt 3 chloride complex, so this complex is basically octahedral complex. So in octahedral complex, four ligands are present in one plane. One ligand is above that central metal atom, one is below that central metal atom, and three chloride are present outside the coordination sphere. So basically, these amines, means NH3 groups, are directly coordinated to the central metal atom, which are secondary valencies, and those three chloride, which are shown on dotted line, are basically in primary valency. So they are outside the square bracket. The number and the arrangement of a ligand in space determine the stereochemistry of the complex. So based on that number of ligands, so directly coordinated to the central metal atom, are responsible for the stereochemistry of that particular complex. The postulate of Werner coordination theory were actually based on experimental evidences rather than theoretical. So as I discussed that these were actually experimental evidences than theoretical. So many of theories were put forth on basis of theoretical evidences. So this was the theory which actually put forth by the experimental evidences. Although Werner's theory successfully explained the bonding features in the coordination compound, it has some drawbacks. So drawbacks are basically, it doesn't explain why only certain elements form a coordination compound. So it failed to explain the number of there were n number of metals present on a d block element. So there were n number of metals, but only some metals can form or few metals cannot form a coordination compound. So Werner's theory failed to explain that certain metals or certain elements cannot form a coordination compound. So second drawback was, it does not explain why the bond in coordination compound have directional property. So as we have discussed that we write that coordinated bond as a directional. So arrow we show that the representation of that coordination bond by arrow. So it is directional in nature. So Werner's theory fails to explain this directional nature of that bond. third drawback was it does not explain the color and the magnetic and the optical properties of the complexes. So Werner's theory failed to explain why the coordinated compounds are colored in nature. So it failed to explain also failed to explain the magnetic and the optical properties of the complexes. So magnetic means either it is diamagnetic or paramagnetic. Optical activity means, or optical property means, it is L director or D director. So it failed to explain the optical properties of that particular complex. So these were some drawbacks for the Werner's theory. So application of Werner's theory for this is the example of, or application of Werner's theory. So based on cobalt complex, so cobalt 3 amine. So there were four examples showing that there is a change in NH3. So in first example, we see that the cobalt Cl3.6NH3. So there are six amines, then there below that there were five amines, then below that there were four amines, then below that there were three amines. So if we treat these complexes with AgNO3, silver nitrate, so they gives different types of complexes. So in first case, we will get the 3AgCl, that is precipitate of silver chloride, which is white precipitate, and then the formation of CONH3 6 Cl3. So that Cl3 are basically present outside the square bracket, which shows that three chlorides are ionizable, so present in ionization sphere, that is primary sphere. So as we seen that there were two types of valency, so primary valency and secondary valency. So in that case, so in this case, for example, in case of first example, so CO Cl3 6 NH3, in case of this, so we get three precipitate of 3AgCl in presence of silver nitrate AgNO3. So this means that the three chloride are in primary sphere, that is ionization sphere. In case of second example, so CO Cl3 5 NH2, so we will get two precipitate, or two moles of precipitate of AgCl3. So this represent that two chloride are present in the primary sphere and other six NH3 are present, sorry, 5 NH3 are present in a primary secondary sphere, and one chloride is also present in a primary sphere. So there are only two chloride which are in ionization sphere. In case of third example, there were only one chlorine which is present in primary sphere, that is our ionization sphere. In last example, there were no precipitate of AgCl3, that is there was no chloride present in a primary sphere. So all ligands, that is 3 NH3 and 3 chloride, are present in a secondary sphere, so they are directly coordinated to the central metal atom. So by means of this assumption or this application, we can find out that how many ligands which are present in a primary sphere and how many ligands are directly coordinated to the central metal, that is present in a secondary sphere. So by means of application of Werner's theory, we can find out that one. So so Werner proposed putting all molecule and ions within a sphere in a bracket, and those free ions that dissociate from the complex ion when dissolved in water outside the square bracket, that is, so in that table 24.1, so same examples are there, but the complex formation are different. Then at the end, the modern formulation, we can see that there were the formation of those complexes. So in first example, that is COCl3 6 NH3, so color of the complex will be orange in color, and ion per formula unit is 4, that is 3 chloride will be precipitated outside, and that complex, though CONH3 6 and having a plus charge or plus 3 charge, are separated. So there were four ions formation. So ion per formula unit are 4 in case of first complex. So there were 3 free chlorines which are precipitated at AgCl3, as we see discussed. So formula for that complex, so first complex will be CONH3 6, and 3 chloride are present outside the square bracket, which are in a primary sphere. So basically that square represent the metal and the ligands which are directly attached to the central metal atom, which are present in a secondary sphere, and outside the square bracket which represent the secondary valence, sorry, the primary valency, which are ionizable valency, which are present outside the square bracket. So similarly, there were other three complexes having a purple color, green color and violet color respectively, and ions per formula unit are 3, 2, 2. So these were the complex formation, and the modern formulation will be at the end of the table. So there were 2 chlorine in case of second example outside the square bracket. So there were 2 chlorine in primary sphere. In case of third example, there is only 1 chlorine outside the square bracket. And also in case of last example, there is 1 chlorine outside the square bracket. So in primary primary valency. So in the last two example, there is one trans and one cis. So in case of trans, the 2 chlorine will be opposite inside, and in case of cis, so 2 chlorine acquire the same side. So in case of octahedral complexes, if there was present of two different ligand, similar ligand in opposite direction. So for example, in case of octahedral complexes, we will see the square planar geometry, and then one ligand is above the metal atom and one is below the metal atom. So this is transposition. If they are on same side, that is cis position. So ligand, the molecule or ion, we have discussed this one. So the molecule or ions which are coordinated to the metal atom or ion are known as ligands. For example, in case of potassium ferrocyanide, so this example K4FeCN6. So six cyanide group are coordinated by Fe2+, that is directly coordination with the central metal atom, are basically known as ligands. So ligand can be negative ion, positive ion or a neutral molecule. Ligand are Lewis acids, so Lewis bases as we discussed, and the central metal atom will be Lewis acid, so central as we discussed below previously. So coordination sphere, so as we discussed that there were two coordination sphere or two valencies, so primary valency and secondary valency. So in case of coordination sphere, there were two coordination sphere based on structure or arrangement of those ligand in square bracket and outside the square bracket. So in case of coordination sphere, so first coordination sphere or inner coordination sphere and outer coordination sphere. So first is coordination sphere. So in coordination sphere, the ligands which are directly attached to the central metal atom in a square bracket is known as coordination sphere. So the number of ligand which are directly bind with the central metal atom are present in a coordination sphere. So the other ligand which are present in a primary sphere are present in a outside the square bracket, which are present are known as primary valencies. So charge on the complex ion. So the net charge carried by the complex ion can be calculated by the following formula. For example, the charge on ion will be Fe2+, for example, in this case. So plus there were six ligands. So charge on each cyanide is -1. So +2 +6 into -1. It is equal to -4. So the net charge on a complex will be -4. So the complex ion can be cationic, anionic or neutral. So based on the charge on that ion, so the net charge on that complex ion defined the nature of that complex. So it will be, in this case, it is anionic complex. If the charge is positive, then it is cationic. If there is no charge or zero charge, the complex will be neutral. So coordination polyhedron, so based on the attachment of the ligand to the central metal atom, so coordination polyhedron will be of these types. So first is square planar complex, then the tetrahedral complex. In square planar, the central metal atom and the ligands are present in a same plane. In case of tetrahedral, so we have you must know the structure of CH4 molecule. So central carbon, then one hydrogen and second hydrogen are in plane, one hydrogen is above the plane and second hydrogen are below the plane. So similar kind of structure can be formed by the metal complexes. So tetrahedral structure, then the trigonal bipyramidal structure. In case of trigonal bipyramidal, central metal atom and three ligands are in one plane, and one is above the plane, second is below the plane. In case of square pyramidal complexes, four ligands are present along with the metal are in one plane and one ligand is above the plane. So this is square pyramidal structure, and then the octahedral structure, we must know that one. Nomenclature writing of the complex compound. The formula of cation, whether it is simple or complex, is written first followed by that anion. So as we discussed that the if there is a cationic complex or anionic complex, the anion is written after the name of cation. So in case of sodium, hexacyanoferrate and the in parenthesis we will write the name of we will write the oxidation state of that metal atom. So within a coordination sphere, the metal atom as well as the ligand are listed without any space between them. So there is no space in between writing that ligand of name of that ligands. So in case of this complex, so potassium, then space and separated by space, then hexacyanoferrate and followed by the oxidation state of that metal atom. So these are some examples of some metals which are the metal complexes which are named in front of that. For example, in case of third example, so AgNH3 twice and then NO outside the square bracket. So this is written as diamine silver. So diamine silver, oxidation state of that silver is 1 and then followed by the name of anion, so nitrate. So in this case, so in this manner we will write the name of those complexes. So in today's lecture we have discussed the Werner-Work theory for the coordination complexes. In that we have discussed many postulates, drawbacks, as well as name of different complexes given by the Werner's theory.